Hey guys, it's Carrie here, and I'm back with another video. This time, I'll be drawing on my Samsung Galaxy Notebook 9 Pro, the 2019 model, the one that came out this year, and I'm really excited to do this video because I wanted to show you guys how this works in its 2-in-1 form factor. How it works when I'm flipping it over, when I flip it over halfway in between, when I rotate it in all these different directions, and I can just tell you, wow, it works phenomenally. Well, first of all, the screen is vibrant. It's not only just beautiful, but it's vibrant. This is at 100% outdoors, and you could see all the light are outside, and usually on most of my devices, it's really, really hard to see when I'm drawing outdoors, except on my Samsung Galaxy Note 10 or Galaxy Note devices, like the phone. But I really am so excited about the capabilities of this thing. Like, the pen is not the best experience, because when I was using it, it didn't block off my hands as good as like my other devices. But besides that, I just love on how bright that it looks outdoors, and that was a big factor for me. And on top of how it scales so great when I switch it on all the different modes, I tried tent mode, I tried it laying down, even I was pressing on those keyboard, but it turned that off. And then I rotated and I tried using the keyboard and mouse, and it just worked flawlessly. Like, that it works so seamlessly, guys, for this illustration. Not even get into the illustration part, I'm just talking about the technical aspect. But just because of that, I was able to ignore that the pen was kind of crappy, that it didn't have, like, the pressure sensitivity is there, but it's not as smooth as I'm used to with my Samsung Norris pencil, like my favorite Samsung pencil ever. But it didn't work with that. But the form factor just works so well. And another contributing factor is this app. The app I'm using is Autodesk Sketchbook, the desktop version. It's not the app version. I had to go and download that on their website, and the UI just works so good. As I flip into the different mode, it hardly glitched, and I was just so thankful for that. It made drawing on it so flawlessly. And another thing about this form factor is that when I switch it over into tablet mode, it doesn't feel like a clunky device. It's actually really light, that I was able to hold it with just one hand. That's astonishing to me, because I'm a person that owned a 2-in-1 device before that could turn into a tablet, but it didn't have a capacitive pen. But when I turned to the tablet mode, it was so heavy. So, but this, it's the total opposite. It's really light, and oh man, guys, I know I talked about the screen before, but I have to give it more praise. Like, the camera does not do this justice. Like, in the very first couple clips, I could see those clearly with my human eyes. The camera doesn't do it justice. And also in tent mode, the hinge is pretty strong, that it can hold itself pretty good. Oh man, that's also another thing. The hinge capabilities on these things, that's also a big worry with these 2-in-1 devices. Like, how long can you flip it back and forth? Well, I can't tell you this early on, but for now, it's working really well as I literally do that in midway towards in my drawing. And speaking about what I'm drawing Sailor Moon. I'm doing this for TikTok. I'm turning her into an e-girl. I thought that was something fun to do, and I was using my iPad as a reference. And this whole video is recorded on my Samsung Note 10 Plus on my selfie stick, so that made it also so much easier to film the whole thing and get at different angles. I really wanted to show you guys how this works, because I know my first video, I told you guys a lot of the bad points of this device to use as drawing. Yes, it's really not the best pen. There are some lags in there. Like, it took me, I had to be really patient to get some smooth lines in there. But because of the form factor of the 2-in-1, and I haven't used a lot of 2-in-1 devices with pens, so maybe this isn't the best one on the market, but the only one that I've used so far with a pen, and I must say that won me over the crappy pen. The pen is bad, but it's not that bad. I was able to create this out of it, and this whole illustration took me 2 hours, but it really hooked me on this device, because this device is not only light, it's powerful. Like, I can edit on this thing. It has the latest gen i7 on there, and I can multitask with this, and it works well with my Note 10 Plus, because it's also a Samsung laptop, so it's so easy to send files from my phone to my computer, or vice versa with Samsung Flow. So they work well together. That's also a whole other video that I'll be making about the Samsung ecosystem. But like, I use this laptop outside of drawing, and it just worked phenomenously, especially with that USB Type-C cable. it works with USB Type-C, that I could charge it with your USB Type-C cable, I could transfer USB Type-C cable. USB Type-C is the future, and that was also another biggest reason that I got this laptop. So I'm just so happy that it handled all my tests, drawing with it, and trying all the different 2-in-1s, because this is actually one of the best ways to draw, and it's so comfortable. And with that being said, I'm wanting to talk about the chin of the tab of the computer, because where the Samsung logo is at, there's a huge black line, and at first I didn't like that. I thought that was just horrible of me to look ugly, but when I turned into this landscape, it actually made it so much more comfortable to draw, because I had somewhere to lay my hands, my whole arm on, and it just was a good way to hold it. It felt like the spiral bind of a notebook, so it felt like it needed to be there. So I'm just so thankful that Samsung added that to their design, and I understand why now as I turn into the different directions. And at first, when I turned this into when I flipped this around, I had to turn into tablet mode because I thought that was disabled a keyboard, but then it stopped asking me that, so I stopped doing that, and it still worked well. And I'm just like, oh wow, this works really seamlessly. And the pressure does work on this. The pressure does work, though. There's still some latency with drawing, but again, I was able to pass that because of the form factor, since it's so light. And this actually works so much better in Clip Paint Studio, which I'm waiting till I have a sale on so that I can do my webcomic. So if you guys enjoy this video, I have more videos like this coming up, and if you guys can't wait for my next video, I'll be talking about my contest, so stay tuned for that. So I'll see you guys in the next video. So thanks so much for watching, and have a good one. Bye.